Hi everyone. In today's GeoSnap, we're going to take a look at how you can use the Flow smart mapping style to really make your data pop. To start, we need to consider what kind of data we're going to be using. We need imagery data. We also need to have a source type of vector, magdir, or vector UV. And this is to indicate that the data has magnitude or direction. I've already added our data to a map, but let's start by changing out our base map to something a little darker. I like the Nova map. It makes me feel like we're looking at a dashboard in a movie. Coming back to our layers, let's start with our wind data here in North America. Choosing our styles, you can see that flow is an option. We're starting with Flowline. And for this, think of Flowline as the body of an arrow and Wavefront, which we'll look at after, as the head of an arrow. Let's increase our speed. We're gonna max out our density and length. As well, we're gonna change our color ramp so that we have a little more variation and reduce the range of values. Already, this is starting to pop. Something to consider is that in our effects, we have bloom already turned on because we're using a dark base map, but let's add in brightness and contrast. Ooh, a little bright. Let's reduce that contrast a bit. Now, let's also add in a drop shadow. Now things are really starting to pop. Now, let's take a look at what Wavefront looks like. Choosing our flow style again, choosing Wavefront, we see we get a sparkle effect. This is because we need to increase the length of our lines, but let's also reduce the width so we get a bit more breathing room. Again, changing and adding in our color ramp, reducing our range of values, going to our effects. We have bloom, let's add in that drop shadow, as well as that brightness and contrast. This is already looking great and something that you can start playing with on your own. We have included these data resources below. Let's see what you make.